I'm Sin with the Osen Dojo, and in this video, we're going to cover creating simple maps for intelligence reports. When disseminating intelligence, maps are a great way to visually show the reader geospatial information. And while mapping can be considered a skill specialization in and of itself, you don't have to be an expert in order to make effective maps for your reports. For this demonstration, we're going to map out a fictitious scenario involving a suspected upcoming short-range ballistic missile launch by the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. We'll be using the free mapping software QGIS. Before we get started, let's go ahead and add in some dependencies by going up to Plugins, then click Manage and Install Plugins. We want to install QuickMap Services as well as ShapeTools. To put down our base map, next we go to Web, QuickMap Services, OSM, and then finally OSM Standard. Since our sample scenario involves the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, let's zoom in on that part of the map to begin. We want to highlight the DPRK so that it stands out from the surrounding countries. To do so, we'll go to Layer, Create Layer, New Shapefile Layer. We'll name this shapefile the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and then change the geometry type to polygon before clicking OK. On the left, we now have the new layer that we just created highlighted. To start outlining the country, we need to click on Toggle Editing and then Add Polygon Feature. Our mouse cursor now becomes a crosshair, which we will use to left-click all around the area we want to outline. For our demo, I'm not being too super accurate here, as I know that when I zoom out from my final image, the individual lines won't be as noticeable. You can zoom in and out if needed, or use the arrows on your keyboard to help move around the map. When you've finally finished, you can right-click to finalize the polygon. Since this is our first mapped item, I'm going to give it an ID of 0. Our completed outline currently covers the details of our base map entirely, and I'm not too fond of the pink that they used either. To fix this, we double-click on the layer, and we can choose some preset options here at the bottom, or we can manually edit the colors by double-clicking here. We can also adjust the opacity, which will allow us to see the details of our base map more clearly. Once we're happy with our edits, we can click Apply, and then OK. Now that we're happy with this layer, we can move on to mapping some individual points on our map. Let's say, hypothetically, we have collected intelligence that suggests that the DPRK is planning to launch a new short-range ballistic missile. This missile is assumed to be capable of traveling approximately 250 kilometers from the launch site. Information useful for our audience might be where these suspected launch sites are located, as well as what areas are within the firing range from these launch sites. To map our suspected launch sites, we once again navigate to Layer, Create Layer, and New Shapefile Layer. We'll name this layer Suspected SRBM Launch Sites and leave the geometry type as Point. Later on, we may wish to use the individual launch sites and show them separately on our map, and so we're going to add a new field type here. The name section only holds a few characters, as you can see, so you are quite limited. Let's just use Site. We'll leave the type as text data, and I doubt the launch site names will use the full 80 characters, so we can just reduce this down to 50 before clicking Add to Fields List. If you decide that you don't want a field, or you made a mistake, you can also click on it and then click Remove Field. Let's go ahead and add sites back in before clicking OK. Our layer has now changed to our new launch site layer. To add our individual launch sites on the map, we click on Toggle Editing, and then the Add Point feature. We once again have a crosshair cursor. However, this time, instead of building out a polygon, each spot that we left click will become a new point on our map. We're going to map out two suspected launch sites. If we click here, we get the option to add our new ID, but also enter the name of this launch site. We're going to label this one as a southern launch site near Sari 1. Our other suspected launch site will be here, and we will label that as the eastern launch site near Wan San. I'm not happy with how these launch sites blend in and make it hard to view on our map, so let's modify them a bit. Double-clicking the layer, I want to first change our option from single symbol to categorized. This lets us customize each point on our map individually based on a specific value, which we will select as our sites. Next, we'll click Classify, and it will show us our different point options. You can double-click the values to edit them here, or double-click the symbol to customize it. I'm going to modify our first site to display as a black diamond with a white outline. The second site will be a black dot, also with a white outline, and we'll increase the size of it just a bit. Our changes are already reflected here, but we also have a third catch-all option. Since we're only displaying two launch sites, this does not apply to us, and so we can click on it and then click the minus button to remove it. Let's apply those settings and get back to our map. These changes do make it far easier to see our launch sites. However, I forgot to increase the size of the diamond. Since we made the change from single symbol to categorized, we now see our unique symbols under our main layer, and we can simply double-click to edit them individually and increase the size of our diamond symbol. Now they look a little bit more in sync. Next, we want to map out the range of the missiles if they were to be launched from these sites. First, make sure you still have the launch site layer selected before going over to Shape Tools here on the right. To display the range of these missiles, we're going to click Geodesic Vector Creation and then select Create Ellipse. Confirm that the correct layer is still selected, and then go under the semi-major and semi-minor axis and put the suspected range of these new missiles. Make sure the radius units are in the correct units of measurement, and then click Run. We now have two circles, which each cover 250 kilometers around our launch site, in a new output layer. Double-click this new layer and click on Source to rename it to Suspected SRBM Range before clicking Apply. Next, under Symbology, we're going to choose the Outline Black option and change our stroke style to the dotted line before applying our changes. This makes our map look much cleaner and easier to read with now just the dotted lines. We now have all the data we need mapped out, so let's finalize and export our map. First thing you want to do is make sure your map on the screen is zoomed and positioned to the same area that you want to export. Then navigate to Project, New Print Layout, and give it a name. From here, click on Add Item, and then Add Map. You will then click and drag to add your map to your new print layout. We're going to go back and go to Add Item, and then Add Legend, which we will click and drag to add in the same manner. To modify the legend, we first need to give it a title. We then need to uncheck both Resize to Fit Contents and the Auto Update boxes, as we want to make manual changes to our legend. I don't want the name of our base map displaying on our legend, so we can select it and remove it using the minus button. Next, let's use the arrow buttons to rearrange the order of the layers to how we want them displayed on our legend. We can also modify the text within our legend by using the fonts and text formatting options. I want to align the legend header to center, and then make the text bold so it stands out a little bit more at the top. Finally, I want to add a frame around our legend. I'll increase the thickness of it, but I think I'll stick with the miter option. Finally, we need to resize our legend and then correctly position it on our map. To export this, navigate to Layout and choose whether you want it as an image, SVG, or PDF. I'll select Image and click Save. If you need a higher quality image for print media, you can adjust your settings here. However, for this demo, I'm going to leave them as is and simply click Save. We received our message that it was successfully saved, which we can confirm by opening the image file. And that's all there is to it. There are far more options for QGIS than the ones shown here, but these very basic techniques should get you well on your way to making your own customized maps to support your intelligence reports.